Hey, it's Professor Dave. I want to tell you about kinetic and potential energy.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We now understand a more rigorous scientific definition of the word energy as being the capacity to do work. But as we said, there are a few different kinds of energy, so we must talk about all of these varieties. First, we will discuss kinetic energy and potential energy. Kinetic energy is the energy an object possesses by virtue of its motion. If we recall Newton's second law, we know that the application of some net force will move an object with some mass at some constant acceleration. We also know that work is equal to force times distance. So if we account for the distance traveled by this object, we get that W equals FD equals MAD, or simply W equals MAD. We also know of this kinematic equation for an object experiencing constant acceleration. If we solve for AD, we get this expression, which can be plugged into the above equation for work. After some simplification, we arrive here, thus deriving the work-energy theorem. This term, 1/2 mass times velocity squared, represents the kinetic energy of a system. So now we can express the work-energy theorem by saying that when an external force does work on a system, the amount of work will be equal to the change in kinetic energy of the system. If W is positive, the system increases its kinetic energy, and the change will be equal to the work done on the system. If W is negative, the system decreases its kinetic energy, and this change will represent the work that is done by the system. Note the presence of mass in the kinetic energy expression. This means that if two objects with different masses are moving at the same velocity, the more massive object will necessarily have more kinetic energy. Now let's discuss potential energy, which is forever intertwined with kinetic energy. Potential energy is the energy an object possesses by virtue of its position in a field, whether that is a gravitational field, an electromagnetic field, or any other type of field. If you lift a ball up into the air, you are increasing its gravitational potential energy as it moves farther away from the ground. If you release the ball, that potential energy is converted into the kinetic energy of motion as it falls. The closer an object is to the center of gravity of the Earth, the less potential energy it has, and as you pull it up and away from the ground, it gains potential energy because it has an increasing potential to fall some distance to the ground. It may seem strange to bestow an object with more energy just by lifting it into the air, but remember that we have to eliminate our prior conceptions of the word energy in favor of more rigorous definitions. The potential energy of a compressed spring or an arrow ready to be released from a bow is where the kinetic energy of motion comes from. It is like a kind of stored energy. In this course, we will frequently be discussing gravitational potential energy for objects on Earth, and for any object, this will be equal to the mass of the object in kilograms times the free fall acceleration due to gravity for the Earth times the height of the object in meters. The greater the height, the greater the potential energy, as this represents the work that can be done by gravity to produce the motion of a falling object. There is also elastic potential energy, such as with the spring or the bow and arrow, and we will discuss this later as well. For now, we just need to understand kinetic energy as the energy of motion, and potential energy as the energy of location. Let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.